Five wagons grope blindly for the path on a starless night, their master glancing ever upward to the skies for assurance that he is on the right course. A dim lantern his only protection against the encroaching darkness. But the skies bring no comfort, shining no light, betraying no hint of what they know. The caravan carries travelers bound for the frontier hamlet of Gilded Vale, you among them, where a local lord has offered land and wealth to settlers from abroad looking for a fresh start. You have taken suddenly ill, sweating and shivering, and one of the other travelers signals for the caravan master to stop on your behalf. He pulls up just in time to avoid plowing into the trunk of a fallen tree that bars the way ahead. You will go no further tonight.
What is it?
Watch and learn.
Stand together!
They'll never know I'm here. Hey there.
Everybody stays close to the wagons, got it? Stay out of the woods, and beasts take you if you were planning a stroll through those ruins up there. Whole area's crawling with hut-dwelling types who'd be happy to stick an axe in you for trespassing. So mind that you don't track mud on their sacred blazing rocks. Tonight, everybody stays put, and in the morning we'll get the path cleared. Gilded Veils less than a day out. Understood? Touch of the rumbling rot, could be. There's a stinging beetle around here carries it. You'll be fine once it passes your innards. Unless you don't drink water, of course. Which case you'll be dead in a day. There's a berry grows in these parts, small and pink. Called a spring berry. About the size of a fingernail. Give you cramps if you eat it, but the frontiersmen make a tea from it. Calms the insides. Should get you through the night. You might check around, see if you can find some. Meanwhile, I'll see if we can scare you up some water. I know you want to hunt before it gets much darker, but see about refilling our water first. Got a sick one here. They grow on a bush that's common around here, kind of funny looking. You'll know it when you see it. Doubt you'd have to go far off the road to find one. Nothing you won't see on half the hills of Air Glonfoth. Money to be made selling their knickknacks in Defiance Bay if you don't mind getting stuck with Glonfoth and arrows now and again. They didn't build them, but I'll be the effigy if they don't watch them like a mother bear. Of course, all the ones around here have been ransacked 10 times over. Got nothing left worth half a pawn, so I hear. Got different names for them. Settlers called them Inguithans. Nobody that liked them enough to stop them becoming ruins, tell you that much. Not if you hurry about your business, and not if the weather holds up. This time of year, rain mostly, and wind. But there's a different kind of wind out here time to time. Locals call it a Beowick, born out of the ether, the spirit's path. Never seen it myself, never care to. They don't got Audra where you come from? Well, it just grows up out of the ground like this. Goes deep like tree roots. Some of it all the way to the heart of the world, you believe the stories. It's more like a shell than a proper rock. Easier to work if you're a mason. Got all kinds of strange properties. Seems to have some kind of life of its own. Dies if it gets dug up. Loses its luster. Folks think it probably grew at one point or another, but not these days. The soul butchers in Defiance Bay use it for different things. I've heard tell it can hold a man's soul, but I don't care to see it. Got enough to worry about without seeing something like that. Hold on. Take someone with you. I know you're not some helpless tenderfoot. Not like most of this lot. But you drop dead, I don't want to be looking for the body. Got a schedule to keep. Kalisha. Kalisha! He needs to find some spring berries. Watch that he doesn't drop dead.
No promises.
What kind of guide says something like that?
Kind you can afford.
Don't listen to her. You're in good hands. And I pay too well, if anything. Off with you. Hayden should have supplies. See that you're equipped before you head out. We're in harsh country. Get your berries and hurry back. And if you get so much as a tickle of wind, you drop everything and you run. Something in the air tonight. If it's a Beowick, We'll shelter in the ruins. Hut dwellers be damned.
You heard the man. Let's get going before you keel over.
Anyone need supplies? I've got sundries for sale. Brought a whole wagon full of goods to sell, but not enough shirts for the road. Say, is there anything you need? I've got...
I'll have your water soon enough. Stream's not going anywhere.
I'll take a peek.
Let's check by those outcroppings. This is it. What a surprise. Sparful went hunting. At least you left the... Sparful? Are you all right? Ambush!
Show them how it's done!
They'll never know I'm here.
Thank you.
Get inside! Run!
That was... We should be dead. We can't stay here. There could be another collapse. We're not getting out that way, anyway. Let's get further inside. We have to be careful in here. Place has been open to the wilds for a couple thousand years. Might be a lot of vermin taking shelter here. Four-legged if we're lucky, two if not. We look for another way out. Storm has to die sometime.
They'll never know I'm here.
Wait, do you hear that?
Show me! I'll teach you a lesson! Show them how...
Thank you.
Shoot.
Oathbinder, bear witness, and see this man has kept his word true to his last breath, full to his blood's last drop. Guide his soul, queen that was, and regard it among your favored. Let his life by the key be his confession. Let his death by the key be his absolution. May he walk the world ever free of the crushing weight. Your brother has done his part, and you have seen the power of his contribution. I will accept no further hesitation from the rest of you. In the sight of the queen that was, will you fulfill the oath? Will you take your place beside your brother in the endless esteem of her memory that is without flaw? Step forth, and be assured of the great worth of your life's course. Thank you.